Imagine investing in stocks, mutual funds, insurance, and more using just your e-wallet. All that for as little as 50 pesos initial or even succeeding investments. These days, Filipinos have access to more sophisticated investment instruments and opportunities.
All right, to tell us more about how this works and the many advances in savings, banking, and investments offered by fintech company GCash, we have Mark Ilao. He is the market education head for GCash and a certified financial analyst. Welcome to the Business Roadshow, Mark.
Happy to be here, Stan and Denise.
Let's talk about GCash, particularly G stocks. It used to be that investing in stocks was a complicated thing. It was a process most often relegated to investment houses, not to mention the costs, which are also big amounts. We're talking about big amounts, but now it can be done by the use of a smartphone and in really affordable amounts if you want to kitty funds to your dream stock purchase. Tell us about this revolution. I mean, are you a game changer in this sense?
Yeah, I guess context first. For quite some time, we've already provided Filipinos access to investment vehicles, particularly investment funds. So for as low as 50 pesos, Filipinos, through their GCash accounts, can put their money in various local and global investments. And we kept on telling them that this is a way for you to invest in stocks, albeit indirectly. Mm-hmm. And one of the key projects that we've been working on, as you mentioned, is G-Stocks.
Right.
So today, we actually have two variations of G-Stocks. One is the G-Stocks game that is already live for all GCash users. So if you're a fully verified GCash user, this is something that's available for you. You can find it under G-Invest. The great thing about this feature is today, you can actually start learning or experiencing what it's like to invest even without any real money involved. So you'll be given a virtual money. And the great thing is, not only are you investing in stocks, but US listed stocks. So it's actually a good experience for people. And to also mention, there are prizes involved here. So actually, people can earn something while having fun. So that's the first variation. The other variation is G-Stocks PH. So beyond the trading platform, the game that we're trying to introduce here, we really want to provide access to Filipinos when it comes to the stock market. And that's something that hopefully within the year, our GCash customers will be able to use.
Mark, I wanted to know, I mean, GCash has 66 million users. Do you see, I guess, people taking part of this? Because usually finance and stocks is a bit intimidating, you know, for everyone.
Great question. I think in terms of wealth management journey, we see that a lot of people tend to gravitate towards conservative products first.
Right.
That's why we also have a product called G-Save. And what we find is that a lot of people, they start there.
Mm-hmm.
Savings is something that's probably easier to understand for a lot of Filipinos. So they start there, they see how it works. And what's great about in today's digital savings landscape, you have a lot of accounts that give you very competitive rates.
Mm.
And that gives them the confidence that, hey, I can earn by doing this. Once they experience actually doing the G-Save part, that's the time these people actually start looking at our other products. The one that I mentioned, G-Funds, and hopefully G-Stocks. So the way I look at it, it's really a journey from being conservative first, starting with the conservative products, going to the more growth products, shall we say, and then to the aggressive ones like these stock instruments.
Okay, Mark, hold that thought. We're leading you in to President Ferdinand Marcos, who's delivering a speech at the Social Welfare Department's launch of the government's food stamp program in Tondo, Manila. Let's listen in.
Of the Dole and all of those, lahat ng ating mga membro ng DSWD, ng Dole, ng lahat ng mga agencies na nakasama rito upang tulungan na mating matugunan ang mga gutom na Pilipino upang makamtan natin ang ating pangarap na sana wala nang gutom na Pilipino pagkatapos nitong termino na ito. Kaya't magandang hapon po sa inyo lahat. Masaya akong makasama kayo sa ating paglunsad ng food stamp program ng DSWD. Batid po ng natin lahat ng I was speaking English as we have members of the diplomatic corps. It is, of course, always the dream of any government, of any leader, that we are able to do something about hunger around our countries. Because that is the most important and the most insidious influence of our people that gets in the way of the development of each individual and thus the entire society. We have always tried to rise up from the throes of poverty, but the problem of hunger and malnutrition still remains. And that's why it has become a priority of this government that we will fight all the poverty, we will put in all the programs so that one day we can say that we are able to give our people, at the very least, the food that they need to survive, the nutrition that they need to survive. We used to use the two terms interchangeably in terms of food supply and nutrition. And by our thinking now these days is that is not necessarily the case. And it is not enough that we just provide all kinds of food, but also that it is of a nutritional value that will allow especially our children and our nursing mothers to become a center of healthful life for their children, for their families, and for their communities. And so we have set up this program. And this program, I'm actually, when the Secretary Rex first came to me and said that with his talks with our the foreign funding institutions such as ADB and the World Food Program, and of course our partners in the different countries from in the persons of the diplomatic corps that are here, I immediately expressed I cannot understand why this is the first time that we have talked about a food stamp program, because it seems to be, especially after the pandemic, it seems to be a particularly important initiative. As we have seen the difficulties that we have had in terms of pricing of agricultural commodities, in terms of the supply of agricultural commodities, and not only commodities but food, so as to be able to provide the kind of nutrition that will make our children, that will make our people healthy and productive in their daily lives. So we have an electronic transfer card, and it is a system that we will use to program. It is not something that we are just starting now. Ipapakita at ituturo din po sa inyo ng mga kawani ng DSWD kung paano gagamitin to. They will show you. The DSWD will go around and will show you how to use this card and how to avail all the benefits that come through this card. So again, let us thank our partners in this very important program. Of course, the DSWD has been the lead agency. The ADB has been, it was actually a part of a discussion when I went to visit ADB. And it was proposed by the Asian Development Bank that we have a food stamp program. And of course, having listened to this rather good idea, Secretary Rex and I immediately jumped upon the opportunity and said, let's not let this lapse. Let's not let them forget that this is something that we would like to do and that finds us here today. So this is the continuing part of all that we have tried to do, so as to be able to achieve yung tinatawag na walang gutom. And for those who are not speaking Tagalog, walang gutom means no more hunger. And that is the dream of this administration. That is what we are hoping to achieve in this administration, that by the end of 2028, we can say that we have done everything to reduce the hunger and poverty in our country and to be able to be sure that we can provide a good, healthy, and productive life for our people. Thank you very much, and good afternoon.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos there on the launch of the food stamp program with the Department of Social Welfare and Development in Tondo, Manila. He was challenging the country to help fight hunger. He also mentioned about malnutrition being one of the biggest problems in the country still, and that this initiative should have been done a long time ago. Now, part of this activity is also a demo on how the card is to be used. DSWD representatives there setting up information desks in the area to help families appreciate and learn more about the food stamp program, which aims to target 3 million beneficiaries throughout the country during its entire run. This is, of course, with the help of other partners of government. Now, we left off with a conversation with Mr. Mark Ilao of GCash. He is the market education head. We were talking about opportunities for investments in the e-wallet space.
And I wanted to also ask, because I did try GInvest, Mark, and the interface is, I think, really simple, which really encourages people to learn more about it. And I mean, with a starting fee of like 50 pesos, not too bad. Did we see an improvement in the interface?
Yeah, definitely. You know, true to our vision of finance for all, we always try to prioritize giving people access to instruments. That's why for our users who have been using GInvest or GSafe for quite some time, they have seen a number of improvements in terms of the interface, the user experience, and they will continue to expect more improvements going forward. Our job is to make sure that investing and saving is easy and something that's unintimidating, and hopefully something that will be part of their lifestyle. So definitely more improvements to come.
Okay, speaking of investments being made easy and convenient, we compare, of course, G-Stocks with traditional brokerage firms. What are the differences, and is it cheaper to trade stocks under your platform?
Well, in terms of fees, people have to understand that the fees are actually quite uniform in the local stock brokerage industry.
So wherever you have the VAT, you have the SCCP, and then the BSE charges.
Right, and the commission of the broker, which is an industry standard. So it's 0.25% per transaction or 20 pesos, whichever is higher. So that's something that you will see across all platforms. So in terms of fees, not much difference really. So I think the differences would be, one is the access, the manner of access. Some platforms would only be accessible via their website. Some platforms would have both website and app. Ours is quite different because in GCash, you know, GCash is something that a lot of people are already quite used to actually using on a daily basis, and without you needing to go to another platform or another app, right there and then you can already access stock investment or in the stock market. So that's one key difference. The other is, as I was mentioning, it's really all about the interface. Okay. If you are able to make it simple for the user, make it unintimidating, the hope is that adoption will follow.
And jumping off from what Denise mentioned earlier about that 66 million base, how's the reception for a product like this one?
I think definitely if you take a look at the overall industry, for example, the stock market accounts here in the country as of 2022, it's at 1.7 million. So there's really a lot of room for growth. And the reason why we wanted to introduce this kind of products, because we think GCash is in the best position to actually deepen the participation in the capital markets, particularly in the stock market. Of course, there has to be a lot of education, as I was saying earlier.
And that's where you come in.
Exactly. Okay. A lot of people, by nature, they are conservative. They don't like to put their money in something that they don't know, or they are afraid to actually lose money. That's why education is very, very important to us. It's something that we really want to provide to our customers, hand-holding them, guiding them as they create wealth in their journey with us.
Now, the best case scenario is that all 66 million users will use this, you know.
Hope so.
But what really specifically is the target market? Who is the generation that you wish to capture with this certain, you know, feature of GCash?
I think inevitably at first you are looking at people who already have excess cash or savings to be able to invest. So you're talking about the SEC ABC class. So naturally, these are people who are inclined to actually invest, or think about putting their money in the stock market.
What about great age groups, for instance? Mm-hmm. Is it more of a millennial or a Gen Z product, or do you also target the older ones?
I think in terms of the target, as you know, GCash, we have a very broad base.
Right.
But the way I look at it from a standpoint of a market professional, I've seen it time and again that young people really have the tendency to be the ones to invest in the stock market for many good reasons. Mm-hmm. One, they have all the years ahead of them. Two, it's something that is exciting, naturally. And people tend to talk about it in social media, within their circle. So you have young people actually participating in these types of instruments, not only in stocks, but even other instruments that have gained quite a number of following the past couple of years. So the way I look at it, you start with young people, those who have the means already to invest, but eventually word will spread. And all the other segments that we might not be targeting, hopefully they will also follow soon.
Can you talk about, I guess, this education that GCash is featuring? How does the pricing work? I'm pretty sure, I mean, like you said, the Gen Z millennials are already quite excited about investing opportunities. How do you think this fuels that even more?
Yeah, so the fact that they have this feature in GCash, for sure, it's something that will actually pique a lot of curiosity, you know, from especially from young users.
What's your assumption growth on this?
Well, we're not putting a specific figure around the growth. The priority really is to be able to put the product in the market. We're working with different stakeholders to make sure that hopefully very soon it's going to be available. And maybe just going back to the education part that you were asking earlier, one of the things that we have done is precisely to create the group that I'm currently heading, precisely to champion education among our users. And the second thing that we have already started doing is we tried embedding education in what we're doing. So inside our website, we created a blog series called Usapang Pera. That's where people can learn a lot about fundamentals of money management, investing 101, savings 101. And as we produce these products, people can expect that education materials, learning materials, will also be available for their consumption.
Okay, we're talking about millennials and Gen Z. I'd like to talk about my age group. The older ones might be concerned about security, which I think is a pressing issue for a lot of fintech products, tech products, security, cybersecurity, in fact, and ease of use. What can you tell us about these activities there for GStock, improving in that aspect?
Well, it's something that is really of a concern for us at GCash. And what we try to do is we always remind our users not to share their MPIN, not to share their OTP. In fact, we created a campaign on social media reminding people about the usual phishing scams or just reminders about not sharing MPINs. And a couple of months back, we actually rolled out a feature we call Double Safe. So this will allow people to actually secure their account, because now not only will you need an OTP, but also your facial verification to be able to access your account. So it's really a reminder that something that you have to be cautious about. These phishing attacks, clicking on links or solicitation from people that are pretending to be someone that you know, we just really have to be guarded. And we rest assured that us from GCash, we always try to do our part to ensure that your accounts are safe.
And moving forward, I mean, we've seen GCash always try to stay ahead of the trends, you know, and I know you just released this new feature, but what's next for GCash?
Well, I guess I just have to say whatever would be specifically for wealth management will be value adding to our customers, whatever possible products they will need to be able to be successful in their wealth management journey. That's something that we're always eyeing. So whether it's a local investment or a global investment, our dream is that one day, whatever Filipinos need for their wealth building journey, it's going to be here in GCash.
And what can we expect in the future as far as market education is concerned? Do you have activities lined up for this?
Yes, definitely. So one is more visibility. Okay. So definitely a lot of on-demand and on-ground learning activities. And like I said, anything that you see in the app, we'll try to embed education there so that people really understand and know what they're getting into before they actually put their money.
All right. What about on-ground activities? Do you have that?
Yeah, definitely. So we're looking at partnering with different business-to-business partners that we already have at GCash. And also, currently, we in fact have a partnership with the Bureau of Treasury for FinLit initiative. So that's something that we'd like to leverage on.
But for the platform, GStock, who are you partnering with?
Currently, the GStocks PH platform, the one that will allow people to invest directly in stocks, that one is powered by AB Capital Securities. So they are a licensed stock brokerage here in the Philippines.
And you have a foreign partner?
The foreign partner is for the global GStocks global game. So that one is powered by EC Equities.
Okay, it's for the game.
Yep.
Okay, for those who want to join in the games, is there a prize or is this something that a lot of people can look forward to in terms of having a good time with it and at the same time learning a lot in terms of investments and stocks?
Yeah, well, I must say right now is actually a good time to get your feet wet. If you take a look at what's happening in the market, global investments are basically leading the charge. And with this GStocks global game, you get to experience what it's like to actually put your money in US-listed companies. So we have almost 700 listed companies that you can choose from, and you're given a virtual money, $10,000 every single week. And then at the end of each week, the top 15 in terms of performance, those with the highest returns, get cash prizes. Yes, okay. So the top one can in fact win as high as 10,000 pesos.
And so, for how long is the duration, or it's a continuing one?
So currently it's live already, and we're looking at until August 4.
What kinds of participants are you having? Are you getting from the games?
Actually,
as long as you're a user, it's free for all.
Exactly. So as long as you are a fully verified GCash user, it's something that you can access, and you'll be surprised with the variety of users that we're attracting, from the young ones to even the old ones. I guess nothing beats learning with free money.
And with a prize at that
exactly.
People can enjoy and, of course, maybe use to invest as well for GStocks.
Yep, hopefully.
Okay, so why don't you invite our audience? Anyone out there might be interested to learn more about stocks. GStocks could be an opportunity for a lot of them.
Yeah, so as I mentioned, GStocks global game is now live for all GCash users. If you're fully verified, you can access it by going to GInvest, and you'll see one of the options there, GStocks Global. So it's a game that's going to be live until August 4. So as mentioned, we have prizes for the top 15 who will get the highest returns. And I actually want to mention that very soon, we'll be able to launch GStocks PH. That's something that will allow you to invest in companies that you love, companies that you're familiar with here in the Philippines.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much for joining us today, Mr. Mark Ilaw, Head of Market Education of GCash. Good luck on your new platform.
Thanks,
thank you
Mark.
So much. Thank you.